can't believe Firewalk is playing a show at the old mill. Fuck yes. Mom would kill me if she knew I was out here. No trespassing? No way. Holy shit. This place is awesome. If I'm gonna get inside, I'll have to get through that door. That saw looks ancient. I wonder how long ago the mill actually closed. I've got to figure out how to get past this guy. I've got to figure out how to get past this guy.
Help you, miss?
You gotta let me in. Check it. I'm totally legit.
It's not a bad fake, kid. But you're in over your head here. Do yourself a favor and scram.
Can't let him push me around. Should I go back and stand up to him? Or can something around here help me convince him? If I owed somebody $1,000, I'd be shitting my pants. Those guys need to get a room. Or not. Damn.
Mind your own business.
I understand, really, and it won't ever happen again, I swear.
This RV's just begging for a little street art. But if I do it here, someone will see me. This place has collected a lot of junk over the years. A second door inside? So close, and yet so far. This band shreds so hard. I gotta get in there.
Hey,
I'd join a motorcycle gang if I had any friends. An old lumber car. Guess it's been years since anyone's actually worked here.
Keep walking, kid.
I guess fire safety isn't exactly high on the agenda here. Some say the world will end in fire. Mom would totally flip her shit if she knew I hiked for an hour just to see a show. This place is sketchy as hell. An old abandoned building in the middle of nowhere, miles from home. Home. Right. Now I remember why I'm here. Any place is better than home. Now, what to draw? Definitely, absolutely not a meth lab.
Really, and it won't ever happen again, I swear. You can trust me. I promise. I really get it now. I do.
Do you? Because trust with me.
That saw looks ancient. I wonder how long ago the mill actually closed.
God, again? What do you want, kid?
Is that your bike over there?
Yep.
It's, pretty cool.
Gee, thanks. Is that all?
This is the old mill, right? I heard Firewalk is playing here tonight. They're awesome.
Nope.
Are you kidding?
You should probably just go.
I have have to convince this doorstop that I'm not giving up until he lets me inside. Don't you remember what it's like to be a teenager? I just want to see the band.
I thought we went over this. Isn't it past your bedtime?
I don't sleep. It's for the weak.
Real cute. But I still don't know you.
Kittens riding tiny mopeds are cute. I'm more like Red Sonja riding a panzer tank.
Okay, kid. I get it. You're tough.
Maybe I am a kid, because this place looks like a damn playground to me.
A girl like you? I can't protect you in there.
Girls? Girls kick ass, you idiot. I can take care of myself.
My boss will kill me if I let you in.
Bosses suck. Screw the man and fuck the rules, dude.
You're not accepting no for an answer, are you?
Nope.
And you really think you can take me?
Yep.
What if I had a knife?
No problem.
A gun?
Don't care.
What if I had...
You could have a flamethrower, an army of robot ninjas, and a motherfucking dragon on a leash in there, and I'd still kick your ass.
I give up. You're all right, kid. Go on in.
This is intense! Shit!
Hey, Delia! Come!
Cute dog. Just follow the lights and the sound. Can't wait to get in there and thrash. Sober up, girl. You're missing the show.
They're gonna sell out. This place is bombed. Okay, go.
Damon Merrick again? Who is this guy? Yeah, no shit. This car could slide down any minute. Looks like that parking brake is the only thing keeping that car from rolling down the ramp.
Look, we have to set this up exactly as I've explained it to you. All right, it's not gonna take any more than...
$20, baby.
$20? That's robbery. And don't call me baby.
Fine, $20, thief.
That guy's a dick. If I want a shirt, I'm going to need to get creative.
No. Look, we have to set this up exactly as I've explained it to you. All right? It's not going to take any more than an hour to do it. If you don't have 20 bucks, beat it.
Still a dick.
No. No, 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 no. Look, we have to set this up exactly as I've explained it to you. All right? It's not going to take any more than an hour to do it.
Sweet knife. Just like the one my mom refused to get me for my birthday.
Okay, good. That's exactly what I'm thinking. Yeah, I mean...
Sketch Central. Everywhere. I think they missed a spot. What are you looking at? Sweet dreams, hombre. Drink more, feel less. Yes, please. No thanks. I try to avoid hepatitis, but I can't. Classy. How can you just chill when Firewalk is tearing it up in the next room? Yo, Frank!
Hey!
Chloe?
I know your name, you idiot. You bought pot for me every month for a year. Look at that getup. Studs. You're trying too hard. What are you even doing here?
I'm here to see Firewalk, man. They rock.
How'd you even hear about this little shindig?
Ha, the internet. How else?
Seriously? Fucking kids.
Okay, so you holding? I could definitely use something to take the edge off.
Of course. As soon as you give me the 175 bucks you owe me.
Shit. Do I really owe him that much? Unless I find some quick cash around here, I can kiss my high goodbye. Never mind, Ben.
Suit yourself.
Half those stairs are rotted through. Looks dicey. Don't you judge me, spooky deerhead. I'm here for the band. There are a lot of people here. Here we go. Fuck.
Hey, you okay?
I'm fine.
Relax. You bumped into me, remember?
off, man.
Hey, you don't know who I am, do you?
No. And I give zero shits.
Hey, let me know how that works out for you,
bitch.
All right. Mosh pit is a no-go. Fine. Maybe I can get a better view of the action from up above.
We're not done.
Then how about I show you how unimpressed I am with limp dick assholes who get butthurt over a spilled beer?
I think she's calling us out, dude.
She's gonna regret every word. Every word.
Oh. This is gonna be good.
I'm gonna teach this little punk some manners.
I'm serious. You wanna see me get angry here? Because I'm getting there. And it won't be pretty. It won't.
She thinks she can take you?
Hey, dickhead. Sometimes, all I want to do is shut my eyes and tell the world...
Daily rituals are important. Even when they involve writing unread letters to friends who have forgotten you. Hey, Max. Hey, Dad. Another day in paradise. Right?
Rolling! Wakey, wakey, eggs and bacon.
Last night, seeing Firewalk live. The skeevy assholes. That girl.
Terrible news, my fellow Oregonians.
Was that really Rachel Amber? You smell like cigarettes and beer. Better change clothes. Bask, ye mortals, in the light of the glowy bear. Dad was so proud of me for winning that stupid science fair. I really should get going. As awesome as some of those shows with Elliot were, they were nothing compared to Firewalk last night.
87.9 FM The Seder is supported by listeners like you. So, you know, feel free to donate money if you want to. Anytime. Literally any amount. We'll take it.
Max made me this mix CD years ago. And because it was Max, not a single song was pirated. Shit! Where's my phone? Not here. How drunk was I last night?
Chloe, I said breakfast.
Guess I better try calling my phone with Mom's. Okay. Mom's phone is probably in her room. I can use it to call mine, then figure out where the hell I left it. How can Mom look at this every day and not see what a tool she's dating? Sounds like my phone is definitely nearby. Mom's hiding her gray hair to impress her boyfriend. Maybe gray hair's his kryptonite. Maybe I should dye my hair gray. The preferred towel of Captain Bluebeard, scourge of Arcadia Bay. There we go. Wonder how many calls I've missed.
Chloe, breakfast. Bring my purse down with you, please.
Yeah. Okay.
I think I saw Mom's purse in her room.
Bad enough that David comes here for dinner.
I hate that she hides all our old pictures of Dad. What's the matter, Mom? You don't want Dad to see your new boyfriend? You don't deserve to be stuck in a drawer like this. It's weird that Mom's always hoarding these old catalogs. It's not like we have any money. Sometimes you have to get knocked down lower than you've ever been to stand up taller than you ever were. Blech. Don't give up on yourself. A single spark can start a fire that burns the entire prairie better. Mom's finally making her bed again? I guess that's a good sign. Mom's old engagement ring. It's a grade B? Fuck you, Arcadia Pond. Wait,
Mom's selling her engagement ring?
No more dawdling. I need to talk to you.
Yeah, that really makes me want to hurry.
Coming, Mom.
Finally, you can put my purse on the dining table. Might still have time for breakfast if you hurry.
Dining table, here I come. Dad took these photos. Now that David's staying over so much, I wonder how long it'll take Mom to shove them in a drawer somewhere.
Chloe, I don't have all day. Would you get over here already?
I should see what Mom wants before she strokes out. Hey, Mom. You wanted to talk?
When I send you a text message, Chloe, like last night, I need you to answer.
You can just say text. You don't have to say message.
And I need you to answer without the snark.
Sorry. I hear you. I'll do better about replying.
Thank you.
Is that what you wanted to talk about?
What is it with you and David? Always cutting to the chase. Why can't we just have some pleasant conversation before school?
You do realize I hate your boyfriend with every fiber of my being, right?
Chloe! You don't hate him.
He calls me girly. He's a dickhole.
He can be old-fashioned.
Yeah, an old-fashioned dickhole. Ah, right. School. My favorite.
You used to love to learn.
Yeah. I used to think drugs were lame, too.
I wish you wouldn't joke like that.
Are you selling your engagement ring?
Chloe, jewelry gets appraised for all sorts of reasons. Like for insurance.
Nice dodge.
How about this? You don't go in my bedroom when I'm not there.
How about you don't ask me to get your damn purse then?
Let's not fight. I made you breakfast.
Nah, I'll just grab something later.
Oh, you'll enjoy this. The other day, I made 4 eggs, 2 for David, 2 for me. And just before I served them, he says, "What are you gonna eat?"
I'll enjoy that, huh?
Tired, huh? That'll teach you to break curfew.
What?
I know what time you came home last night. And don't think you can get out of school just because you missed the bus again.
Why would you assume that—
Who do you think your principal calls when you skip? Do you think I enjoy lying for you, saying you're sick just so you don't get expelled? Between your grades and your disregard for my rules, I see you slipping. I'm worried.
But Mom, the whole point of lowering expectations is so you won't be disappointed in me. Never again.
You're happy doing what you're doing? Fine. Keep at it. Just let me know so I can stop fighting with Blackwell to keep you on scholarship. Money's tight enough as it is.
Maybe David should start paying rent. He spends the night often enough.
How would you know? You're never here yourself. David thinks you need discipline.
David should mind his own business.
I think it's great David's taking an interest. He's a good man. Maybe he can help.
Dad was a good man.
That's not fair. I'm glad Your father still has a place in your heart. But sometimes we need to make more room in our hearts for new people.
And sometimes, when we're incredibly desperate and lonely, we choose the absolute wrong kind of people to let into our hearts. Mom.
David's had some hard times too, you know. If he's kind enough to share his experience, I expect you to listen.
Like I'd let him get within 15 feet of me.
When he takes you to school today.
Very funny.
You will be nice, you will be respectful, and you will say thank you.
Are you serious? This is such...
What, Chloe? Such what?
Mom's trying, I guess. Maybe I should too.
But what's the point in getting along if it means pretending everything's fine when it's not? You want me to pretend I'm okay with David? That everything's okay? I'm not. He's a chauvinistic piece of shit, frankly,
Chloe,
and...
if your father could hear you.
No, you're right. I'm sure Dad and the mustache would get along great. It's a big bed. There's room enough for all three of you.
That's enough. All I'm asking for is a little respect. Why is that too much? I love you, Chloe. I miss you. Nobody could have replaced your father. I did the best I could.
Mom.
I don't know where I lost you.
You didn't lose me.
Right. David's waiting. He'll need the keys. They're in that ashtray you made me. Go be his problem now.
Bringing David his keys is about the most humiliating thing Mom could ask me to do. Here they are. Let's get these to David so he can drive away. No point in putting off the inevitable torture of driving to school with David. They better get going. What a piece of crap. The car, too.
Why do you women always take forever to get ready?
We're hoping you men will leave without us. No, Mom. I swear he beat himself to death with a tire iron. Repeatedly.
Electrode insulator's probably cracked. You know what a spark plug does?
Yes.
It ignites.
Did you not hear me? I said I know what it does.
Then go grab my socket wrench set from the garage, and we can get moving.
What is this? Quality time? Ugh. Better just get the socket wrench and get this over with. What's David doing, leaving stuff in our garage anyway? Does he think he's moving in or something? 50-50 chance I smash him in the face with this. 60-40. Maybe 90-10.
A little more hustle wouldn't have killed you. See what's gunking up the works there? That's a sign of
carbon deposits. No shit.
You know, you could actually be good at this if you lost the attitude.
My attitude is what makes me special, David.
All right.
Fine, whatever. Hey, you're taking those tools with you, right?
Every house needs a good toolbox.
We've already got one, but thanks.
Ready to roll?
Please don't want to talk. Please don't want to talk.
I want to talk to you about something.
Fuck!
We don't have to like each other, but you will respect me. You've enjoyed enough of a vacation from having a father figure. So there are some things I want to be real clear about.
Mm-hmm.
Joyce! Your mother, she's hurting, Chloe. Hurting for you. You've had it rough, no doubt about it. But all this staying out late, ignoring her command, drinking, drug use, it's making everything harder for her. You need to shape up, get your act together, and put someone else first for a damn change. Am I making myself clear?
Is it crazy if part of what David's saying makes sense to me? Got it. Thanks. We should really get going.
Glad we understand each other.
Country music? Dad loved this song. I just called to tell you that I miss you, my old friend. What a beautiful day. Dad, turn it up. I know what a spark plug does, jerkwad. This isn't right.
Picking up my lover from the grocery store.
pay.
The hell?
Out of the car, Chloe. You're gonna be late.
Shit. Thanks.
Don't use that sarcastic tone with me, young lady. I can see you rolling your eyes.
Hello? I was actually saying
I see everything.
I'll warn everything.
Hello, Black Hal.
Hey, Chloe.
Oh, hey, Elliot.
I heard you had a hell of a night. I mean, people are talking about it.
Who exactly is talking shit about me?
You know, haters on social media.
Great. I wish I could tell everyone to just get a life.
So, how about The Tempest? Blackwell Theater at its most pretentious.
Yeah, totally.
I know it's gonna be lame, but I was thinking, do you want to go together tomorrow?
I try to make it a rule not to go to school any more than I have to. But sitting in the back row and making fun of the drama kids might not suck.
Right? That's totally what I was thinking.
All right. See you in camp.
Yeah, for sure.
Gotta track down Steph to pick up my DVD. I've still got time before class. How could I possibly make it through a day in this place without a little chemical assistance? Victoria Chase. I'd rather vomit razor blades than talk to her.
Oh, Carrie Price!
It's Chloe.
Oh, right. I'm just teasing. People have been taking me so seriously since I won the Beacon's Young Artist Award for my photography.
You don't say.
Between that and the Vortex Club, it's hard to keep people from putting me up on a pedestal or whatever. But you know all about that. What with Rachel Amber? Am I right?
Wait. What about Rachel Amber?
Rachel posted a slamming selfie of you two having the time of your lives. Do tell.
It was a pretty normal night for us. A little music, a little dancing. We murdered a guy.
You are so funny. Oh, seriously, though. I didn't realize you and Rachel were such BFFs.
We're really not.
So, what's she into? You know, what's her thing? Is it drugs? I'm not judging or anything. I figure if she's hanging out with you, she must be into some effed up shit. You know?
Seriously, I don't know why you're talking to me about Rachel.
Oh, everybody loves her. Little Miss Perfect.
So you're jealous of Rachel Amber. That's what's happening right now. Gotcha.
Oh, God, I don't have time for this. I didn't even finish the chemistry assignment, and you're being you. Oh. Why would Rachel Amber ever hang out with Carrie Price?
It's Chloe.
What have you got here? Twitch?
Don't call me that!
True North. A jock so dumb he makes jocks look bad. Guess Nathan Prescott made the shit list.
Oh, wow. This is some really weird crap, Prescott.
It's not yours. Give it back!
I hate that you're on the team now. You're such a loser.
Guys, no need to fight. You can both be losers.
The mute speaks? Whoa, whoa! You earn a spot on the squad, Twitch. You don't have your dad try to buy off the coach.
At least my family pays tuition. How much financial aid does your deadbeat dad need again?
Wow. Dick move, Nathan.
My dad lost his job at the shipyard when your dad closed it down. And you want to talk shit to me?
Leave Nathan alone.
You know something, Prescott? I'm gonna do you a favor. You can't be a part of the team and be into this stupid crap at the same time.
You're a piece of shit. I am going to kill you.
You guys, stop. Chloe, do something. Don't just stand there watching.
Hey, if you don't take the time to stand back and watch, you miss some of life's finer moments. Like...
Booyah!
That.
That took me months to put together!
Quit the team, Twitch. Or next time it'll be worse.
Go to hell.
You should be ashamed.
Maybe if I delay going inside long enough, Blackwell will be overrun by future excellence. And by future excellence, I mean mole people. Need my DVD from Steph. I bet she's nerding it up with Mikey somewhere. Morning, Miss Grant.
What do you think of this hypothesis? That you'll be in your seat by the time chemistry class begins today?
I wouldn't miss it for all the manganese in the world, Miss Grant.
Your sincerity's overwhelming. With all the change that's happening at Blackwell of late, I suppose I can appreciate your consistent wit, Chloe.
What kind of change do you mean?
Well, the Prescotts have made an extremely generous donation to the school, which is good, but instead of going to support more science and mathematics, it's all being dedicated to the arts.
You don't think more money should be spent in the arts?
It's not that exactly. I recently made the case that STEM programs should receive more support, but apparently our new donors disagree with me. Such is life, I suppose.
Miss Grant actually seems sad. Maybe in another 6 months, a new donor will come along with money for, I don't know, more lasers.
More lasers?
Do we have any lasers?
Sadly, no.
That is sad. Steph and Mikey normally post up somewhere quiet in the courtyard. No, Chloe. Class is back the other way.
Chloe, I'd like to talk to you about wildfire awareness and prevention.
Good morning to you too, Evan.
According to the Department of Forestry, over 90% of this season's fires were caused by humans. That's a record high and completely preventable.
This is for college, right? I don't believe you actually care about this.
My interest in fire prevention is completely sincere. Besides, I intend to get into college on the strength of my photography alone. Do you think Rachel Amber would be willing to pose for my portfolio? She's so artistic. I bet she would be a dream model. What do you think?
I guess. Who says we should prevent fire? Fire is awesome.
While I realize you're being purposefully obstructive, you raise a good point. Many parts of our local ecosystem benefit from fire. Knobcone pine cones, for example, which require temperatures above 350 degrees to open.
Say knobcone again.
No.
I gotta run.
Wait, one last thing. Will you sign my petition to have a fire safety assembly at school?
Sure. I love assemblies. Some of the best naps of my life.
Wow, thanks. I did not see that coming. You being, you know, interested in complicated issues, helping out with the public.
Do you want me to change my mind?
No.
How seriously am I taking this right now? There you go. Just don't expect this to become a habit. Blackwell Academy, home of tomorrow's leaders.
What? Caring about important issues?
Caring in general.
Hey, price check. Gotten in any good trouble lately?
Last night, I scoped out this crazy party at the old mill up north. Kind of a DIY thing.
Wow, no shit. I thought that place was like meth central. My cousin met this hooker there.
Whatever. It was cool, okay?
You wouldn't understand. Hey, out of the blue question, what do you think of Rachel Amber?
She is amazing. If you're into chicks that are hot, smart, and hot. I mean, she helped me out a while back. I was failing algebra hard.
I believe you.
Check it. After I bombed my midterm last fall, she tutored me for the rest of the semester. And then I crushed it. C+.
Huh. All right. Guess I'll see you in class.
Word.
If I had known the Celestial Avenger was bloodied, I would have totally given him my potion.
It was a skill challenge. Potion wouldn't have worked.
Skill challenge?
It's part of the tabletop game we play.
You wouldn't understand.
Give me a break, nerds. I've heard of tabletop games.
Cool. Now that is a creature I wouldn't want to fight.
Got my DVD?
One Blade Runner. Director's cut coming right up.
Sweet. $5, right?
Keep it. I'm just glad someone here appreciates the classics. You even asked for the director's cut, which took out the shitty voiceover and replaced it with a sweet dream sequence.
Dream life over real life. That's my motto.
Right on.
Hey, do you know if Rachel's a gamer?
Rachel Amber? You're asking me?
Didn't you two go out last night, or was it just like a friend thing?
I don't know what you heard, but Rachel and I barely know each other.
Oh, sweet.
Steph has a crush.
Chloe, you should join our game.
Yeah, I don't have 50 hours right now. Thanks, though.
We're at the end of the campaign, so it'll only take, like, 20 minutes? What else have you got to do before class?
What the hell? Game on, nerds.
Here's a character sheet. You are an elf barbarian.
Are you insulting me in some obscure nerd way?
Think about it. An elf? Like, skinny and kind of weird, but also a barbarian, so, like, really angry.
In other words, Chloe Price.
Wow, you two are a riot.
All right, let's get started. You are both famous heroes in the Kingdom of Avernon, a once peaceful land, now laid to waste by the bloodthirsty raiders of the Black Well. Alone, you have fought your way through the raider camps, seeking their warlord leader, Durgaron, the Unscarred. As you enter the final camp, bloodied and weary, you see your fellow hero approaching from the opposite direction.
I raise my staff to you in greeting. I am Elamon, Wizard of the Third Circle, foremost advisor to King Tiberius, and sworn defender of Avernum.
Introduce your character.
Yeah, okay. I'm an elf barbarian named, Barb.
No, Steph.
Hey, give Barb a chance, okay? The two heroes.
Hold on. Elamon narrows his eyes at the elf in front of him and says, I am here to defeat Durgaron, the Unscarred. In the name of King Tiberius, what makes you think you are worthy to fight alongside me?
It says right here that I taught your precious King Tiberius everything he knows about fighting. So, Elamon, what makes you think you are worthy to fight alongside me?
You gave her that, elf barbarian.
I did.
Elamon bows deeply. I've heard of you in the castle. King Tiberius owes you his life. It's an honor to fight alongside you.
Damn straight.
You stand at a three-way crossing. To your left, the Raiders' training ground. To your right, their prison camp. Straight ahead, an enormous, ostentatious tent that could only belong to Durgaron, the Unscarred. Which way do you go?
Straight ahead, right? We're supposed to kill the Durr dude.
Elamon frowns. The Raiders could have some good loot at the training ground, and surely it is our duty to free all those prisoners.
Your choice, newbie. Where do you wish to go?
Yeah, I'm done here. Peace.
Really? We were just getting to the good stuff.
If you go now, you can't rejoin later.
Sorry, I gotta go do something that's not this.
Oh, all right. See ya, Chloe.
Yeah, see ya.
DVD, check. Next stop, chemistry class. Joy.
Oh, good. You're here.
I do beseech you, chiefly that I might set it in my prayers. What is your name?
Miranda. Oh, my father, I have broke your hest to say so.
Good. Admired Miranda. Indeed worth what's dearest in the world. Many a lady I have eyed with best regard, and many a time had listened to... Many a time the harmony of their tongues... Hath I listened to...
Hayden, you're killing me. You've had weeks to be off book.
Sorry, Mr. Keaton.
No, don't apologize to me. Apologize to your scene partner, who's been very accommodating, and to your other fellow actors, and most of all, to yourself.
Mr. Keaton, sorry to interrupt, but does this look better? I had my mom take it in a bit.
Rachel looks awesome. This is getting as surreal as last night.
Looking good, Rach.
Very cool.
Exquisite Rachel, as always.
Mr. Keaton, I'm still having trouble with... My affections are then most humble. I have no ambition to see a goodlier man. I mean, does she really mean that?
Especially because I just straight out told her I've been banging all the ladies.
Yeah, that is hard. We've talked about that line forever. We need a fresh perspective. The question is, are Miranda's feelings of instant passion for Ferdinand just inexperience in dramatic circumstances, or has she actually just met the love of her life? What do you think?
Sometimes, when you meet someone who's going to change your life, you just know it, I guess. Also, you've got parents coming to see the show, right? At 20 bucks a ticket, it's gotta be true love.
Wow. A romantic and a cynic. That actually kinda helps me. Thanks. Thanks, Mr. Keaton.
Later.
See you later, guys.
Oh, no. I have first period improv with a class full of freshmen now.
I'll just be a minute.
Okay, so why am I here again?
Oh, could you grab my belt for me? I think it's in my bag over there.
Yeah, sure. Okay, get the belt. Don't say any stupid shit and don't, like, fall down. Should be doable, right? Rachel looks so happy here. There's Rachel's belt. Guess I'll go give this to Rachel now. I have feelings about this. Most of them are not good feelings. Rachel, is this your belt?
Yes! Thank you.
I really liked your costume.
Thanks. So?
Did you bring flowers for my dressing room?
How about a belt instead?
Perfect.
I'll let you finish changing now.
Chloe Price.
Rachel Amber?
Last night was amazing.
I'd never seen Firewalk live. Pretty fierce show.
We'll have to do it again. To tell the truth, I went to bed last night wishing it never had to end. But then I thought, why? Why does it have to end?
Maybe it doesn't have to end.
Exactly. How would you like to join me on a little field trip?
Fuck yes. I was born to ditch.
Let's get the hell out of here.
You sure you don't want to just grab the bus, or?
Nope. If we're gonna go rogue, we're doing it right. Well?
What the hell am I getting into here?
Where does this thing go? North? Maybe we'll end up in Seattle. Pull up a chair, Price. The view's amazing.
Rachel wants me to pull up a chair? Maybe one of these...
Guess we're not the first ones to hop on this train. I wonder what the symbols mean. Thing's heavier than it looks. Guess I should sit down. All right, Chloe. You're on a freaking train with Rachel freaking Amber. Play it cool. Is this nervousness? Is that what this feeling is? Wish Max were here so I could ask. Should I make small talk? Is that what people do? It's nice Rachel we're having.
What?
I mean weather. It's nice weather.
It sure is. So, it's kind of weird that we're hanging out.
You mean because I don't hang out with anyone and I don't have any friends?
You have friends.
Well, I used to. Friend. Singular. Her name was Max, but she left for greener, more northern pastures.
That sucks.
I didn't mention it earlier, but you seem to have some kind of Jedi mind powers over Mr. Keaton and the theater crew.
You mean when we were talking about true love in the play? I guess you could say I'm good with people, yeah.
Just don't pull that stuff with me.
You will get on this train.
Oh, shit.
I bet you're wondering what we're doing.
The thought occurred, yeah.
Well, I wanted some company.
That's it?
That's it.
Good to fucking go. Anything beats another second in Blackwell.
You really hate it there, don't you?
You don't? Right. What reason would Rachel Amber have for hating Blackwell Academy? Your high school royalty.
You don't know me. Yet. Let's do something fun.
V-card's been punched, Rachel. I'm sorry.
Wow.
Too far?
Well, I don't know.
Okay, something fun. I'm all ears.
Two truths and a lie.
What?
I think we should play Two Truths and a Lie. It's a game where each person offers up three facts about themselves, two of which are the truth, and one of which is
a lie.
Right. And then the other person has to guess which is which.
Sounds fun. You're on.
I'll start. First, I'm ambidextrous. Second, I was born in New York, the land of fashion and Broadway, to which I will one day return when my heinous exile here in Arcadia Bay comes to an end.
New York, huh? I've never been.
Not a world traveler?
Not yet, at least.
If you could travel anywhere, where would you go? Russia, Greece, Kathmandu?
Kathmandu?
One day, I'm going to climb Everest.
And I thought moving away from Arcadia Bay was ambitious. What's your third thing?
My third thing?
Two truths and a lie. You say three things.
Right. I'm a Leo. Meow.
Okay, so ambidextrous, born in New York, and a Leo. Gotcha.
So, which is the lie?
I don't buy the ambidextrous claim.
No? Well, that's too bad, because it's true.
Prove it. Sign your name with both hands.
Sign where? Seriously?
All the bad girls do it. Come on. Damn.
I'm afraid the lie was New York. I'm a Cali girl, born and raised.
So New York's on the bucket list.
Broadway, here I come.
Cool.
Okay, your turn, Price.
First fact. Right. Something about myself. Should I start things off with a lie or with the truth? Or should I cheat? Let's see how good she really is at this game. Sad to say this, since you're a Leo and all, but I'm allergic to cats.
Are you now?
Swear. I love science. Seriously, I think Neil deGrasse Tyson is the shit.
Huh.
I used to love country music when I was a kid. Now it makes me want to throw up. Literally.
That's weird. You're hella mysterious, Chloe Price.
Hella? Who says that?
It's a Cali thing. Anyway, I think I have your number. I'm not sure why country music makes you throw up.
I'm a complex girl, Rachel.
I think it's probably true. Also, I kinda like the Dixie Chicks.
You and David both. No accounting for taste.
Who's David?
He's, the guy my mom's seeing, I guess.
Oh. And you don't like him.
It's still so weird that she's dating someone. My dad and my mom, they were totally in love. You can tell how fucked up she is now just by how she's settling for David. He's this total hard-ass ex-military jagoff type. The opposite of my dad.
Oh, that sucks.
Yeah. David has no respect. He acts like I'm some kind of problem to solve. Sometimes I am a problem, though.
That's a load of bullshit.
What do you mean?
You're not a problem, Chloe. You're a person. It sounds like the only problem is David. You need to hit him where it hurts.
The only thing that David loves has four wheels and a four-barrel carburetor.
Oh, God. A muscle car?
I'm probably going to steal it soon, so.
Let me know if you need an accomplice. Okay. You say you love science, but you are failing chemistry.
You're saying failing chemistry means I hate science?
Or that Blackwell doesn't inspire your best work.
That place is a hellhole filled with shit, where shitty people go to be shitty to each other and themselves.
Tell me how you really feel, though. Anyway, school sucks, but you love science. I'm gonna say true. Which brings me to your alleged cat allergy.
Alleged?
I'm calling lie.
Why is that?
I mean, maybe you're allergic. But I've passed by your locker a few times. And I've seen that old photo of a cat you keep in there.
You've passed by my locker? Stalker much?
Hey, I notice things. I can't help it.
I guess you're no stranger to being noticed, too. It's kind of new for me.
Well, get used to it. So, if my math is correct, you told me 2 truths and 1 lie.
What? You expected me to cheat?
Winners make their own rules, Chloe.
You are crazy good at this game.
A lifetime of studying the human condition.
No, I mean you're really good at this game. It's kind of creepy.
I have a hard time imagining what creeps Chloe Price out. When your dad is the district attorney, I guess lying is something you're used to.
Seriously?
Seriously.
I know who to call if I need to get out of a ticket then. Not that I have a right of my own. Car first, embarrassing number of moving violations second.
Hey, thanks for trusting me.
Trusting you?
You played the game. Also, you told me about that dickwad David. Now he's on my shit list too.
Hell yeah. Mustache brain won't know what hit him.
I guess. You opened up a lot. That's all.
It's not a big deal.
Hate to break it to you, but Chloe Price is not exactly renowned throughout Arcadia Bay as a bastion of trust and empathy.
Trust doesn't exactly come easy to me. Maybe if you'd had my life, you'd understand.
No, I get that.
On the other hand, I got on this train with you, didn't I?
Fair point.
Wouldn't mind listening to some music. Hey, wanna listen? Bracelet.
I've had it, I guess, since I was a kid in Long Beach. It reminds me that there's more to experience out there than just Arcadia Bay. Maybe one day I'll go back to Long Beach, or anywhere but here. Maybe sooner than later.
What brought that on?
Sometimes I feel like I've got no reason to stay. Don't be surprised, Chloe, if one day I'm just out of here.
Let me know if you need an accomplice.
Check it out! We're here!
What? Where is here? Jump and find out! Did you say jump? Jump! No way! Scared?
That's not the Chloe Price I know.
Trust me, this is the only Chloe Price there. Huh!
Hey, it's actually a pretty nice view. Glad you approve. And as your reward for making it up here, I have a new game for us to play.
Another one?
I like games. Deal with it. This is one I learned in theater class. It's all about improvisation.
So far, what I've learned about you is that you're into acting, lying, and playing games.
What's your point?
That you're either full of imagination or full of shit.
Let me know when you figure out which one. This game involves spying on people from afar. Luckily, we've got some high-tech surveillance equipment right here. Let's fire it up.
That blows.
Well, shit. That was my last quarter. You?
Quarterless.
Damn.
Hey, maybe I can MacGyver something up. I've been told I'm pretty handy.
Oh yeah? Let's see what you got.
Rachel really wants to use this viewfinder. I'd love to get it working for her. Huh. Looks like I might be able to pry it open with the right tool. I'm not getting in there with just my fingers. Maybe Rachel has something I can use? I'm thinking about prying open that viewfinder. Got a knife on you?
A knife?
Yeah. My mom took mine.
No. How about a nail file?
I guess you could stab someone with a nail file.
Oh, right.
Sure, let's try it. Damn it. It always looks so easy in the movies. I wonder if I can find something sturdier to use. That's not gonna work. I need to find something else. Totally gonna get you that quarter.
Love the confidence. Would love a quarter even more.
I'm gonna need a bigger prior majigger. Dwight Mueller really killed it with this statue of an explorer guy. Where are all my explorer ladies at, though? Probably at home, washing laundry and spitting out kids. Fuck you, Dwight. This Blackwall guy sure liked founding stuff that was already there. Founders keepers, I guess. Get out of here, woodland creatures. Have some self-respect. Stealing a dedication plate takes persistence. Prescott power, activate. I don't want to boast, so I'll let you do it for me.
Chloe Price, you are truly the Viewfinder Whisperer. I stand in awe of your powers.
Rachel smells like jasmine. Is she smelling me right now, too? Really should have showered this morning.
All right, here's the game. You find some people for us to spy on, and then you and I will act out what they're saying and thinking.
That's it? I do that in my head during, like, every class.
See? You're a natural. Let's give it a try.
Hey, what do you say we barbecue some squirrels when we're done here?
God, you just have the best ideas.
All right, let's see. Why do we always hold hands like this? Didn't you tell me you were ambidextrous?
No, I didn't. I said I was ambisexual.
Oh, so you can have sex with both of your hands?
Exactly. Wanna see?
Only if you let go of my hand first.
What's going on with these two?
And the Lord saideth, thou shalt make a burnt offering of your firstborn son.
Who are you talking to, Dad?
No one, son. Now,
Lean into the grill and see if the fire started.
Further.
Further.
Wow. That was dark. Too dark. Perfect dark. Loving this guy. What's he thinking right now?
No matter how fast I go, I'll never outwalk this wedgie.
That's so tragic, but also beautiful in its own way. This is fun. Who's next? Oh, sorry. Didn't mean to hog the viewfinder. Ooh, jackpot. Commence makeout session in 3, 2, 1. Nailed it. Damn, they are really going at it. Oh, honey. I think we used the vibrating bed for too long. I'm totally seeing double. Rachel? Hey, are you all right?
What are we doing?
Excuse me?
Last I checked, you're supposed to be Chloe Price. Yet we've been ditching now for hours, and we haven't even gotten wasted yet. That's got to be against some school ditching rule.
Hell yeah. The honor student wants to show the school delinquent how to party? Be my guest.
How gracious of you.
They have a bottle of wine.
Let's steal it.
Okay. Or we could go try to find a liquor store instead.
No. You shouldn't bring alcohol to a public park if you're not willing to share it with everybody, right? And fuck it. I just want to take something that's not mine. All right. I'm going in. Try to keep up.
Can we help you? Oh my god!
Holy shit. Talk about committing to a performance. Better act fast.
What do we do? Oh, thank god! Please, this girl is in trouble. Go get help.
I need to get these two to focus on Rachel so I can swipe the wine.
What are you waiting for? Go! Hold on. There's something off about this. Are you girls putting us on? Rachel! Run!
What the hell?
So, maybe your acting could use a little work, but at least you committed to the performance.
No, thanks. You're the one who really worked for it.
Suit yourself. I am excessively sober right now.
Right. Okay. Guess we're leaving now. Whoa. Hey, check this out.
What?
Great. It's a pile of trash.
Yeah. An awesome pile of trash. Let's explore.
You have fun, Chloe.
I'm gonna go sit down. Rachel's been acting kind of standoffish ever since we left the park. What's her deal?
I've heard that actors are moody, but wow, Rachel.
I'm not moody. I just need some space. Is that all right with you?
Okay. Actually, no. I thought we were having a great day together. Why are you acting like this all of a sudden?
I'm not acting like anything. I just want to be left alone right now.
No. I don't understand. You can't just turn on me for no reason.
I'm sorry, turn on you? I guess I forgot. It's always about how you feel, isn't it? Sad Chloe's fucking sad again. Maybe you should try giving a shit about other people for once.
Are you serious right now? Fuck!
Okay, I still have no idea what's going on with Rachel, but apparently, she gets smashy when she's angry. I can work with that.
Score. Hey, check it out.
I don't always drink beer, but when I do, I prefer drinking it next to an old toilet.
Home run!
Can I see?
Sure.
I asked you to leave me alone.
Are you kidding me? I know you're the school princess and all, with the DA daddy and the perfect grades and all the perfect little Victoria Chases kissing your perfect ass. But seriously, fuck you.
Great. I'm leaving. See you around, Chloe.
You can't leave!
Watch me.
Rachel, wait! Don't go. Why not? Because I don't want to ruin this the way I ruin everything else in my life. And what is this exactly? A real friendship.
Oh. Is that all?
I mean, I don't know. Yet. But I want to find out.
I thought Chloe Price doesn't need friends.
I thought so too, before today. I guess it's easier to be alone if you decide it's a choice. I'm sorry for whatever I did or didn't do. Today was the best day I've had since my dad died. And I screwed it up somehow. Like I screw everything up, because I'm a fucking screw-up.
Chloe. Please. I don't want to be alone anymore. I'm sorry, Chloe. I can't say why, and I know it isn't fair. But I can't
be your friend right now. Can't or don't want to. Does it matter? I'm really sorry. Goodbye, Chloe.
Fuck this place.
Faking Hollow. Who else do I know who fits that description?
Yeah!
Fuck off, Rachel. If you want to rip a family apart from the inside, it's important to bring the proper tools. Fuck you, David. I'm not finished. Not yet.
I've never understood your hard-on for cameras, Max. He took a million pictures of us, and not one of them showed that you were gonna leave when I needed you most. Fuck cameras.
Dad.
Why are you crying, sweetheart?
Because you're not real.
I'm not.
What is going on? I guess I did that.
Kiddo, look on the bright side, would ya?
What bright side?
You made a new friend today.
I don't feel drunk.
Gotta say, that was some fight. She nearly took your head off.
What do you care?
Sorry, sweetheart. I guess I'm getting into your personal business.
What's past is prologue and shit.
Sometimes, people need you, though. Even when they don't admit it.
Rachel!
You came. I'm glad.
Are you sure about that? I got kind of a different message this afternoon.
Yeah. Chloe, I want to talk to you about something, but I don't know how to talk about this.
You don't have to tell me anything you don't want to.
You remember that guy that we saw under this tree with that woman?
The ones who were making out?
That was my dad.
Oh. All right.
And that woman was definitely not my mom.
Oh.
The worst part is, I'm not surprised. I felt like my dad's been lying about something for a while. I didn't know what it was. So when I saw he got a text from an unknown number asking him to meet, I thought I could catch him or something.
I'm so sorry, Rachel. I don't know what to say.
Neither do I. Chloe, I love my dad. I love him. And I never want to see his fucking face again.
When my dad died, I was so mad at him. For months, I felt wrong because half the time I thought of him, I wanted to scream. And the other half, I forgot.
Forgot that anything had changed. It's silly, but I've carried this photo around with me for years. It's from Mount Hood. My dad took me hiking there when I was 10, and it started raining, and I fell and broke my arm 3 miles from the car. I remember screaming like I was gonna die, but my dad, he carried me down the mountain. I still remember the smell of his coat, and how calm he was, and the sound of his voice, and he was just so strong, you know?
I felt safe.
You trusted him.
Completely.
Here.
Chloe, I owe you an apology.
Don't worry about it.
No, I mean it. Whatever's going on between us, it's intense and new and awesome, and maybe you just see it as a friendship. I don't know. But I put you on the spot, and I could have handled that better. I'm sorry.
Rachel, after the day you've had, it's okay. I mean it. We have all the time in the world to figure out whatever this is.
I just want you to know I'm lucky that you were with me today. You're a badass, Chloe Price.
What?
Remember that biker asshole who wouldn't let you into the mill? You talked your way right past him.
You saw that?
And those skeevy douchebags who followed you upstairs? Two against one. But you wouldn't take any shit from them.
I'd be dead if you hadn't thrown that bottle.
You inspired me. See? You're the real thing, Chloe. I don't know anyone like you. Plus, you came along with me, no questions asked.
Well, I don't really need a good reason to ditch school.
I guess tomorrow there'll be hell to pay.
My mom might skip grounding and just go straight to the death penalty.
And my dad will definitely punish me with...
I'm so sorry, Rachel.
Fuck him.
What I wouldn't give to leave this place and never look back.
What's stopping us?
Us? Are you serious?
There's nothing keeping me here. Not anymore.
So, if I came to you tomorrow and told you to pack your bags...
I'm serious. Let's do it, Chloe. Let's leave this place forever.
Okay.
Can I borrow your lighter? Thank you.
Come on.